I'm Cliff Rouse.
And I'm Derek Lee, and tomorrow we're going on a year-long trip around the world!
We're going to film the entire thing, and we're going to post it online as a travel blog.
It's going to be epic. Terrific movie, seriously.
Thanks.
I really enjoyed it. It was, I mean, on the surface it looks like a found footage movie, but it's really, what I like about this movie is you can't really boil it down to just one thing.
Yeah.
It's a vampire movie, it's a found footage movie, but at its heart, I think it's really about friendship more than anything else. And I was just curious, what was the process of writing the screenplay like? I mean, did you start with one idea and did it just develop from there?
The concept itself was a marrying of two ideas that aren't normally put together. So something as fantastical and as over the top as vampires and juxtaposing that with found footage. And the reason why that was super important to the project in the beginning is that we weren't super stoked necessarily in either part individually. And it was taking them and putting them together and saying, what if we were to take this creature that is normally so romantic, so sensual, that's actually mostly a good thing because you live forever, it's beautiful and stuff, and going, let's make this feel real by using found footage, and let's make it scary and biological and a damning curse. And that part all of a sudden got us super excited, and the whole script sort of built from there.
I think the reality part too, we felt that when documentary style movies are at their best, you really feel like you're not watching actors in a movie, you're watching real people in real situations, and that's where we kind of gravitated to the idea. We always knew Derek was going to star in the movie, but we were like, okay, you're not going to play a character, you should play yourself, and let's just take a genre movie, drop it in our actual lives. Our friends will be our friends. We'll cast me as myself. Derek's family in the movie is his actual family. Those are actual friends. And hopefully you just get this sense that the entire film is infused with an authenticity you couldn't get if we were making it up.
In regards to like the specific genres, were you looking to avoid any sort of cliches like with vampire movies, or did you want to play on them at all?
Yeah,
we definitely wanted to stray away from the stuff that felt more magical and fantasy based and grounded as much in biology. Like, what would this look like if it actually happened in real life? And about it would basically be a human being transforming into the perfect predator, and hence stuff like super strength, super speed, and night vision, and then stuff like no reflections or aversion to garlic, that kind of stuff we would just stay away from.
The scenes that really got me were the scenes where your character jumps up.
Yeah.
Onto the buildings. I mean, with a budget as tight as the one you had on this movie, how were you able to pull those shots off?
Very big cranes and very brave stunt. Brian Ho is my stunt double, and with the guidance of Laura, our stunt coordinator, we basically just actually did what Derek would need to do. So we strapped the camera onto a chest rig, put the chest rig on the stunt guy, put the stunt guy in the cables, and used what's called a ratchet to just basically launch him like a catapult at a building or across a building or whatever. And it was a huge like laugh riot watching these things fly around, watching the stunt guy fly around, try to get the shot, try to be in character. It was tons of fun.
Yeah, and I think one of the other keys was to break those shots up. Everything in the movie is supposed to feel essentially like one shot. But we would take, you know, there's a SWAT team sequence at the end of the movie. That feels like one shot. It's actually more like 25. And that way we could get each piece, make sure we had that, and then move on.
What was like the biggest challenge in making this film on such a tight budget?
What was the biggest challenge?
There's a bunch.
Yeah. I mean, I think the advantage that we had once we realized that the concept was best executed using a documentary style was that was something we could do with a small crew and not very much gear. And that's what allowed us to then take, you know, our small crew of basically seven people and fly to Western Europe and shoot in these spectacular locations and put what little money we did have on screen.
I think the probably, if I could sum it up, the primary disadvantage of the limitation of the budget was the more money you have, the more control you can have over the environment and the moving parts in any particular scene. So, for instance, something as simple as being able to reset a big special effects gap, like the wall that it punched through. The more time and more money we had, the more times it would have taken that. Instead, we had three takes. And the third take, even that one, we weren't sure if we should do it because it'd take another 4 hours to do, it was going to start the next day. Hopefully on the next project we'll have a little bit more time and money. Time we did have, money we didn't. So.
One of the ironies too is that because when there's less money involved, that actually also means there's less strings attached. So we had a lot of creative freedom and the ability on our first film to sort of, you know, find our feet on our own terms.
Yeah.
I imagine you guys shot a ton of footage for this.
Yes, we did.
Is there anything you had to leave out that you wished was in the film? Or?
there's yes. One particular sequence where near the beginning of the movie where the characters go skydiving. And it was a big moment for the two characters, and Cliff, both me and the character, are afraid of heights. And Derek convinces him to jump out of the plane. And at the end of it, it's just one of those life-changing experiences. And it was a great moment. Every audience that we showed to often would rank that as their favorite scene in the movie. But ultimately, it just took away from the overall film. And that was definitely one that was really hard to cut, but it had to go.
Yeah.
About to bust in on Derek and the girl he just picked up.
Call an ambulance. Wake up! Call an ambulance!
What happened?
I don't know. I don't remember.
But the morality of it, and not a...
I guess I owe a dollar.